Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Kenyon Sports Connections presentation of the Scott Thielke Show. I'm Matthew Ruskan. With me is Coach Thielke, head coach of men's and women's tennis, and our special guest today is Wade Heerboth. Thank you both for joining us.
Thank you.
Coach, we're going to start with you and go over to the women quickly. As, you know, the women have had some ups and downs in the past week, but they ended on a very high note with a 9-0 win over Ohio Wesleyan. What did you like there?
Well, obviously, we were a stronger team than they were, and we got through the match with very little issues with close matches. So that's always good to kind of get through those matches fairly easily. The women had a really good win against the University of Findlay as well, beating them 5-4. It's a Division II school with lots of international kids, so that was a pretty good win for us. So the last two matches have been real strong for them.
Well, jumping over to the men now and bringing Wade in, you guys had an entire week off with a rain delay on a match. How has that helped you prepare for the rest of the season?
Well, I think the biggest thing for the men is we've been going on the road ever since the middle of February, and we haven't played anything at home since then. And so we kind of needed a break away from traveling and away from playing matches and being under the pressure. So I think that will kind of get us a little bit more rest and a little bit more ready to go into the rest of this fall or rest of the spring season.
And Wade, what about you? What are you thinking about this break, and how has it helped you prepare?
I think this was really good to have. It's nice to be here on a couple weekends without having to be on an 8-hour, 10-hour bus ride like we had the couple weekends before. I think it's really good to be able to practice without having the pressure of knowing you have a big match coming up. And we actually have one today against Denison, which I think is pretty important, but like, we don't have a series of three matches in a row like we've been having. So I think it's good to be able to focus on hitting a lot of balls, doing a lot of fitness, just getting in shape without worrying about hurting ourselves before a big match. And I think it's just nice to just have a smaller break from competition just to get us back in before a conference tournament and then regionals at nationals.
All right. Well, now everyone's favorite part of the show is the off-topic topic, and it is Division III week. So we wanted to know, what about a Division III school appeals to you, whether it be something specific about Kenyon or just Division III in general?
For me, one reason I wanted to come to a Division III school just for athletics is I wanted to come to a place where I could win the national title because I personally hate losing. So going to a Division III school, I want to be the best. I would like to win an individual national title for myself, and then I really want the team to win the title. And then one thing that's nice about Kenyon is I just love the small school. You recognize everyone you see. And even like people I don't know, I know what they look like. Everyone I see, I recognize. And I think it's just great to have that sense of community here.
And Coach, what about you? What about being at a Division III school appeals to you?
Well, I think it's quite different than what I experienced when I was in college. I played Division I, and we basically were probably out of class as much as we were in class. And I think that's a huge difference is the Division III athlete is there for school first and then athletics second. And that definitely wasn't the case for me when I was in school. And so once I started coaching at the Division III level, that became pretty obvious to me that school takes a lot more time than what I put into it. And so I think it's a great place to be. You can actually be a student and an athlete at Kenyon. And so I think that's why Division III is probably a much better choice for most people.
Well, focusing on Wade a little bit, and Coach, we're going to start with you to get your take on this question, and then jump over to Wade. He's played at both number one and two this season and been successful at both spots. Why do you think that is?
Yeah, well, it's because Wade's a good tennis player. I mean, it's a pretty easy one. There is a difference between playing at number one and playing at number two because the matches are always going to be fairly difficult at the number one position. But for Wade, he's used to high levels of competition. So I don't think it's a huge deal for him to jump from one to two and back and forth. And he's obviously done a great job at it. I think probably if – I don't know the statistics exactly, but if you look at it, his record probably is just as strong at number one as it is at number two. So for him, I don't think it's a tremendously big deal.
Wade, what about you? Why do you think you've been successful at both positions this season?
I've just worked pretty hard this semester. And last semester when I was abroad, actually, I trained with someone from another school who is one of the top players in the country for Division III. So I think just playing with him a lot actually just got me used to playing at a really high level. So even though I only had one person to train with, I was playing with one of the best people in the country. So I think I just got used to that high level of competition. I think that's really translated over to this year. And I just love competing. I love playing matches. So no matter who I'm playing, I want to win. And it's a lot of fun for me. So I think that really helps me just play at a higher level.
And Coach mentioned the difference between playing at number one and two, the quality of players. You've played at both this season. Have you noticed a difference there?
I think against some of the best schools, there's actually not necessarily a huge difference because they have people that are very good all the way through. But at some of the smaller schools, they'll be not a very good team, but yet they'll still have a good one player. And so I think against in those matches, I think there's a big difference. But I think in general, either way at one or two, I'm going to be playing someone who's very tough, and I have to bring my A game each time.
Well, you mentioned your A game. A lot of people don't get to see you play. So, you know, if you're playing well, if you have that A game, what should we be seeing?
For me, I think it's just really focusing on my footwork, because I think when I'm there, like in position, I can hit pretty much any shot I want, but I'm not really a fast player compared to most people. Like, I'm one of the slower ones on the team, but one thing I have to work on is just making sure my feet are always moving, and I have very good anticipation. So as long as my feet are moving, I can get to just as many balls as everyone, just because I know where the ball is going. And so I think as long as my footwork's going, I think that's when I'm playing well.
Well, for all the fans out there, April 14th at Oberlin, as well as at the College of Worcester, at 4:30 p.m., if you want to come out and support the Lords, I know they'd love the support. For the Kane Sports Connection, I'm Matthew Ruskan. Coach Thielke, Wade, thank you both for being here.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next week.